Traditionally, to start every Monday morning assembly, the whole school will recite the Pledge of Allegiance. On September 8, 1892, Francis Bellamy wrote and published the Pledge of Allegiance. He wrote the pledge as a response to the Civil War, which was still fresh in the nation's memory. He hoped to be used all over America, just like it is today. The patriotic song, America the Beautiful, was written by Catherine Lee Bates and was published in 1895 as a poem. She was inspired to write the poem after taking a trip up a Colorado mountain. The song is now one of the most popular and patriotic songs of America. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for America the Beautiful. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Friends and family, we welcome you here today to the graduation ceremony for the class of 2022. We thank you all for coming here today to celebrate this special occasion with us. Regardless of how long any of us have been here, whether we have been here for just 3 years or 11, we have all shared many memorable moments together. Ever since I started here in preschool, I have made amazing friends and memories that I will never forget. All of these memories are memories we will cherish forever. We would like to thank everyone, especially our teachers, for guiding us and helping us. They have taught us to show leadership, respect for others, and responsibility. We are all prepared for the new challenges we will face as we go on our separate paths. Thank you.
In this year's eighth grade class, we have 5 students who have been here at CCDS for at least 11 years. For these students, Kent Country Day School is the only school they have ever known. Now, I would like to introduce you to these students. Our 11 new students are Lucy Dubel, Nadia Kishka, Brooke Schumacher, and Everly Spilios. And our 12-year student, Stella Zimmerman. You will all be remembered here, and I know that all of these students have valued every moment here at CCDS. The word legacy has many meanings. It can be a gift, a trait, or a quality. At CCDS, a legacy student is a student whose parents have preceded him or her from graduating here. This year, we have 3 legacy students. Please stand when you hear your name called. Lucy Dubel and her parents, Maxwell Dubel, class of 1989, and Jen Dubel, class of 1986. Liam Kendall. Kendall and his mother, Amanda Kendall, class of 1995. And Brooke Schumacher, and her father, Paul Schumacher, class of 1980. Congratulations, and we hope the legacy continues. Thank you.
At CCDS, each year the graduating 8th grade class raises money to buy a gift to help Kenton Country Day School and the community. The money to purchase the gift is raised by the 8th grade class through an annual car wash and bake sale. This has been a tradition for many years. Our gift will contribute to the school during pep rallies, the first day of school, open houses, and other events, not only in spirit, but in happiness and fun. The class of 2022 wanted to give the school a new cougar mascot because we thought that it was time for a new one. We all thought about a gift for the school and how a gift would be able to represent all of us, and the cougar mascot just felt right. We hope that this gift will be used for many years to come. Mr. Humphrey, we hope that you like our choice, and it is now my honor to present to you the gift from the class of 2022. During our time together at CCDS, we have shared many happy memories, but the 8th grade camping trip is definitely a memory to talk about. For most of our class, going camping in the middle of nowhere, setting up tents, and camping for 2 nights and 3 days did not sound like our idea of fun. When we first got there, we started to set up the tents, but before we even got started, it began pouring down rain. We immediately had to stop since our gear was getting soaked. We put everything in our bags, including our phones, and went to the nearest pavilion. By this point, we were starving, but the only thing we had to eat was a big box of Rice Krispie Treats. We sat underneath the pavilion for 5 hours eating our Rice Krispie Treats before it finally stopped storming. We came back to all of our things being soaked and Everly and Stella's phones being broken from water and heat damage. At this point, we just wanted to go home and be inside. The next day, it wasn't raining, but it was over 90 degrees and very humid. Half of our class went to the lake to cool off, but Stella, Everly, and I did not find that amusing since the lake was about a 45-minute walk away. We stayed back, and while everyone was swimming, we went to the shop and got ice cream and a large pizza with whatever money we had left. That was definitely the happiest we were on that trip. The third day, we woke up, and the only thing we could think about was showering and the bus ride home. So after 2 broken phones, spiders crawling in our tents, and clothes being ruined from the weather, we realized that camping was definitely not our thing. However, being all together and with each other definitely helped us get through it and made the experience so much better. Thank you.
Thank you. Music is such an important part of Canton Country Days, and it is important to me as well. When I joined the CCDS community, I joined the guitar elective. Not only did I learn to play guitar, but I made some good friends. Because of music and the connection I have with it, my time at CCDS has been the best 3 years of my life. Our eighth grade song is Over the Rainbow by Aracel Komikaui-Ulai. He grew up on an island in Niihau. It was here where he spent his summers with his grandparents. Because of his time spent here, he grew deeply connected with his Hawaiian heritage. Our class chose the song because it is happy and calming, and we wanted to have a happy ending to our eighth grade year.
Thank you.
Mr. Humphrey has been our head of school at Canton Country Day for 1 year now, but he has been a part of the CCDS school community as a parent for 9 years. His four children have all attended CCDS. Mr. Humphrey has 14 years of experience in the education field, including as a teacher, a coach, and serving as a director at the administrative level. Mr. Humphrey wants to continue to provide an environment that fosters innovative and empathetic young learners. He is kind, funny, and caring, and always knows how to make a joke. Even though he has been the head of school for 1 year now, it feels like he has been here so much longer. I know that Mr. Humphrey will continue to do great things for the school. I'd like to present to you our head of school, Mr. Humphrey.
Good morning, and welcome to the Canton Country Day school class of 2022, 8th grade graduation. You're almost done. About 30 more minutes, you'll be all right. Nah, I'm just kidding. Today we come here to celebrate amazing individuals that are sitting up here on stage. And I think it's fair to say that the last 3 years have been nothing short of eventful. I'm sure when you were in lower school, as we announced our 11-year and 12-year students earlier, you couldn't wait to get to middle school. Couldn't wait to do those cool middle school things, right? And then you got to middle school. And you got to your spring break in sixth grade year. That spring break lasted a long time. Right? And I'm sure there was a lot of uncertainty. Would we ever come back in? Would we have Zoom classes, right, till we got to high school? So then you returned your seventh grade year, and luckily we were partially open. Right? But you came back to a year of masks, social distancing, some virtual learning as well, a lot of events canceled or rearranged maybe. So then that brought you to the beginning of this year. A little more regular classes, but you came back masked again, social distancing, with a lot of protocols and policies in place, and it just wasn't the way it was supposed to be. And now you're here sitting up here on stage today celebrating all your amazing accomplishments in the midst of 3 years of craziness, actually, right? And there are some important things you learn from that. You know, I've always said that it's easy to learn from those who show you how to do things right. I'm fortunate enough to have a lot of examples in my life that taught me how to do things right, and I learned from them. But it's even more important, where I've learned the most, is when maybe things weren't exactly right, or maybe things didn't go exactly to the plans that I had. Because they taught me a lot about how to handle other things as I get older and deal with different experiences. What's also awesome about this class is each and every one of you have an amazingly unique personality. And there's nothing more valuable than entering the uncertain ground of high school with a strong understanding of who you are. Self-awareness is crucial to your success, and you have to celebrate your uniqueness and be unapologetic about it. So let's go back to the first day of your eighth grade year. None of you thought I'd be talking to you on your last day of your eighth grade year. And I didn't think so either. It's funny how things work out, right? So what did we talk about when I made you come up in front of everybody and you were so happy about it before you got rain-soaked and sun-beaten on your camp trip? We talked about enjoying every minute of every day of that final year because it's going to go by fast. And we talked about leaving your mark and leaving your legacy. Whether you're aware of it or not, you've left a legacy. As we look out in the audience and we see our student body today, you've left a mark with them. We talk a lot about character education. The banners are right above you. And those are all a good foundation to character education, but there's a few others that maybe they haven't been emphasized but they definitely will be emphasized moving forward because we've learned them over the last couple years. Resiliency is a characteristic of the class of 2022. You've all lived through unprecedented world events, not to mention challenges individual families have had over the last couple years. And the lesson is you can always do hard things. You can hold your head high and face challenges ahead. And don't be afraid to make a mistake. You do have to fix it. But don't be afraid to fail. Always remember to value education. Always be inquisitive and open to learning. B.B. King once said, "The beautiful thing about learning is that no one can take it away." At the same time, remember to stop and notice the simple things. We live in a world that moves 100 miles an hour all the time. It is okay to pause. It is okay to slow down. Enjoy the moment. Some of you have been cougars since the start of your schooling, as we talked about earlier. Others have joined your class along the way. Always lean into the foundation you have established here at Country Day. The relationships you have built with adults and students within these walls are invaluable, and they're forever. My hope for you is that you rely on this strong foundation that you've gained at Country Day, and you use it as a springboard into your future. And always, always remember that door is always open. Like it or not, you're a forever part of our family. And you don't have to ask permission to come home. So on behalf of myself, the Board of Trustees, the staff of Kent Country Day School, we wish you the best of luck in high school, and we look forward to sharing your future success, as in a few minutes you will be alumni of Kent Country Day School. Thank you.
Lucille Brooks Dubel. Sarah Jean Gressens. Madeline Lily Harris. William James Kendall. Nadia Lee Kishka. Brooke Nicole Schumacher. Everly Alexandra Spilios. Stella Lee Zimmerman. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor and a pleasure to present to you the Canton Country Day School Class of 2022.
After today, we will no longer be students at Canton Country Day School. But this school will always be in our hearts. It has been our home for so long, and we know that this school has more than prepared us for our futures, and for that we will always be grateful. Even though we will no longer attend school together as students, I know that we will always stay close to the people we spent our time with. Some of me and my classmates have been here for our entire educational lives. Over those years, the school has taught us how to be good citizens and good people. We have made so many great memories, and I know that we will hold those forever. This school will forever be close to our hearts for the connection and love that the school has shown us. On behalf of the entire 8th grade class, I would like to thank the faculty and staff for helping us grow and helping us learn to become good people. Some of the staff members have been here ever since we were just in preschool. They've watched us grow and have molded us into the people we are today. We would not be where we are today if it wasn't for them. And I know that we will never forget the kindness and love that they have shown us. From the greetings every morning to the goodbyes every day, they have shown us that a little bit of kindness can make a person's day. I know that we'll remember what they have taught us and how they've made us feel and take it with us for the rest of our lives. I would also like to thank all the parents of our class. You are the reason we are here today. You have helped us our whole lives with the big and the little things. We appreciate everything you have done for us. Thank you for always contributing your time and energy to the school and always looking out for the well-being of the school. We love the connection we all have, and we know that those connections will last a lifetime. Thank you, parents, for loving and caring through everything. I would also like to thank all of my classmates for being the best friends I could ever ask for. We all have such a strong connection. Ever since preschool, I knew that these were my people. They have always had my back and have always stuck by my side. Distance means so little when someone means so much. I know that even though we were all moving in different directions, we will always have the connection through CCDS. This school is special. It's a family. So thank you for all the joy and happiness that the school has shared with us. And finally, thank you, Canton Country Day School, for always being our home away from home. Thank you.
Thank you.